What's going on?
Hey, hey!
How's everyone doing? You all right?
Good!
Before I even start, Alicia, thank you. All right, you gave me the golden buzzer. You changed my life. I'm famous now.
Hey!
But I'm still broke. And I still live in the hood. I'm getting recognized in places I don't want to get recognized, like Lidl in Croydon. Right? I'm pushing my 20 kilos of onions I bought for 50p, and I'm like, oh my God, it's him. Can I get a picture? Can I get a picture? Can I get a picture? I'm like, yeah, sure. Sure, let's have a picture. We take a picture. Oh my God, I'm a big fan. Not as big as you, though. Oh my God, I can't wait to go home and show my kids, right? I can't wait to show them that I met Big Nasty. I said, that's cool. Can I go now or am I still being detained, officer? Some people watching will think, oh, it's another one of those Black Lives Matter guys doing jokes about stop and search. No, it's a joke about being fat. Yeah. Big Nasty and I are both fat. We just happen to be black too. Don't throw in the race card, guys. When do black people ever get mistaken for each other? Especially not by police. No! Listen, I didn't even want to come out here and talk about race. But seeing as we're on the topic. Now, every time a black comedian puts on TV, you see like angry far-right guys come out, because obviously there's so many other types of far-right guys. You see angry far-right guys come out, yeah, look at that, mate, look at that. It's terrible, right? Look at him doing jokes about being black and Muslim, right? If a white non-Muslim did that, it would be racist. Well, duh. Like, that's like me saying, oh, look at that guy kissing his wife. It's romantic. But if I kiss her, you know, it's just... I don't get these studies. And the thing is, I tried to explain to someone, you know what? We just tell jokes about our lives because they matter, right? And in the face of things, I was recently talking to my white liberal left-wing friend because we all have to have one, you know, because if I get killed, someone has to start the GoFundMe. And come out on the news, like, he was such a pillar to his community. And it's official because he said it. And he tells me, he's like, Nabil, rude boy, Femalam, big man ting, I just want you to know that I am not racist, okay? My best friend is black. I said, brother, I'm your best friend, I know. Why are you telling me? He's like, yeah, but Nabil, seriously, I just want you to know, I don't even see color. I said, that's why you always lose that snooker, right? You should get medication for that. I was like, no, Nabil, I just want you to know that I've been studying and I found out that if you just adjust your chakras, the energy you put out to the universe is what comes back to you. I said, okay, Tarquin, and? He said, well, I want you to know that if you just forget that you're black, nobody will be racist to you. Okay. Why didn't I think of that? So I listened to him and I forgot I was black. 1 hour later, somebody reminded me, right? I was out shopping, walking through the fruit aisle, and I found that I acquired a bodyguard that I didn't even pay for. Just followed me through the aisles. He must have been a cheap bodyguard as well, because he wasn't even discreet. He was walking with me. I turned, I was like, look, boss man, I know you're trying to protect your shop, but you're wasting your time. I'm not a shoplifter, okay? Shoplifting is a crime that generally requires lots of running. Now, I know the stereotype is that we're fast, but it's relative. You know what? I think racism is a sad thing. Like, you know, recently with COVID and with, you know, we've had people at home, we've had lots of alcohol, we've had Wi-Fi. That's a bad combination. Because you go online and you see people talking things they should not be talking. Like one of my friends came out, he proved himself to be the worst type of racist, right? And these guys, they're so empowered by the internet, because the internet is the only place you can say whatever you like and not suffer any consequences, unless your name is Wiley. And you should have known better. Oh, Wiley, man, I'm so disappointed. No, but my friend came out and he said, I'm not trying to, and why do they always qualify, right? I'm not trying to be racist, but, right? Why do racists think that their racism is less racist when they say they're not trying? That's like me saying, hey guys, I'm not trying to be Muslim, but Allahu Akbar, right? It doesn't, I'm not trying to be racist, right? But these Somalians, these Indians, these Bangladeshis and Nigerians need to go back to Pakistan. I said, bro, what? He said, listen, mate, I'm not trying to be racist. I said, that's what's scary. You're not even trying. Like the Michael Jordan of racism. Thing is, I think really we were creating different tribes and nations so that we may get to know one another, right? The only way we can eliminate racism is if we walk a mile in each other's shoes. And I think sometimes bad things bring us together. England is better now because of what's happened. Because look, England is one of the best, in fact, the best country to live in, bar none. But look what happened. Rich country, but we were fighting for food in supermarkets. We were losing our jobs. Our hospitals were crowded. We were trying to get into other countries and they weren't letting us in. But the weather was fantastic. For one summer, England felt what it was like to be African. And, you know, the most amazing thing is this, right? We had no toilet roll. That's right. Absolutely no toilet roll. So people in England had to learn the proper way to use tabloid newspapers. Yes. I'm joking. Don't use them for that. They're full of... Anyway, what I'm saying is the newspapers came out. I don't think that they spread knowledge. I think they teach us to hate and teach us to fear. Right? Newspapers came out online and tried to scapegoat Muslims. They came out and said, yes, yes, yes. COVID is a threat to Great Britain, but not as great a threat as Islam. I'm like, bro, how are you just going to throw us under the bridge like that? We took a holiday from being public enemy number one. It really upset me. So I went out for one of my government mandated half an hour walks that normally took about 5 hours. And they never called me because I wrapped my phone in foil. But I went out. You know, they constantly make Muslims out to be this force that's trying to take over Great Britain. They try and make us as if we're trying to change the culture here. And it was so upsetting, right? They think we're at war with England, we're not. But while I was out, I noticed the people weren't shaking hands. They were walking far apart from each other. The pubs were closed. And people were covering their faces. I was like, oh. We won! We won! Alhamdulillah! We won! La ilaha illallah! Now, before I go, people, I just want to say, I understand that comedy is subjective. So if I've offended anyone watching at home tonight or in the cinema, sorry, it just looks like one. But anyone, anybody offended, so at home or in the studio, I just want you to know, if you're upset by anything I've said, it wasn't me, it was Big Nasty. You guys did great. Thank you and good night.